We'll be right back. graduated from that. As soon as I graduated from high school, I graduated like early. And I just kind of ran away. As soon as I could, fame and fortune. Yeah. When you're a dancer, you can only act with your form with your body. I think I had a lot of things to say in other ways besides.
Quick update, ladies and gentlemen. We do have the match finishing up, and it looks like we have a 1-1 series, ladies and gentlemen. It's tied up, going into game number 3. So we essentially have a best of 3 moving forward from here. We just have a few more minutes. Somebody's got to figure something out, and then we'll have game 3. Stick around.
We'll be right back.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are getting the lobby set up here. And it's time to make it happen. Game number three, we have a tied series, 1-1. And it's certainly going to be a doozy. 1-1 tied series between the defending champs and the contenders. We got Jay, we got V, we got Pew, we got Triss up top. Republica. And I believe it, Gash, if I remember correctly. Ladies and gentlemen, you ready for game three? It's time to go. Game three, locked and loaded. Triss, Republica, Gash versus JV and Pew. Random Protoss, Terran Protoss, Terran Protoss. It's gonna get crazy. Let's go. Let's get ready, ladies and gentlemen. The countdown has started. Random. We have Terran Protoss, Terran Protoss, Terran Protoss. It's all Protoss, Terran, Finagle, Biggles. No Zerg to be seen. If we missed out game two, I may be able to cast that later from replay. But it's time to get into it, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to get crazy. Let's go. So looking at our lineup here, waiting to see what we're gonna have on the first wave. First wave will go over to Jason, no contest. If we bring up production, we will see Orange is going up for that tier two. We're gonna have a clear victory here. Now we're waiting to see here. What's interesting is I think we do have Triss waiting to see how he wants to respond. Waiting to see how they want to respond to the wave. So they see stalkers and they see the sentries. So what will be the call? So far, nothing has gone down for Triss. I wonder what the plan is here. Because they're going to have a wave. They're gonna have a wave go here unless they drop something. So here's the decision. They drop a bunch of bio late just to make sure, just to get it in right before. And I think that actually might work out pretty well. We'll find out. So far we have advantage. Advantage to Pew Power. Now getting through there, that hallucinated Archon soaking up so much damage. And Pew Power continuing to put pressure on, continuing to keep the advantage here. Will it stick? That's the question. Will it stick? And there's the upgrades you see there. We got Stim and Combat Shields coming in for these Marines. And they're going to be able to get some damage onto this bunker already. Down to 6, 5, 4, are you kidding me? 3, 2, 1, no way! 55, 24! Oh my god, is it going to happen again? Will we have another situation where it was so close? And yet so far! Will Squirters ride this again? Are you kidding me? 11 in the previous series of the semis. This one in the finals is down to 24. And they are pushing over the line. This is crazy. Either the perfect calculation or the perfect fortune. It's only one or the other. Stims come through. You see the hallucinations almost die immediately. Guardian Shield is not enough, and Orange right now is unable to stop the Bio Army. Orange is going to have to come up with something to stop it. Has gone up to Tier 2 and has gotten the double. Is trying to go for Guardian Shield plus double armor to stop. To stop the damage from the Marines, to try to reduce it as much as possible, because Marines just do such a small amount of damage, but they do have the upgrade. They have one upgrade at least. We do see Tier 2 for Red. Pink dealing with the yellow wave, no problem. Damage up here. You can still see this on fire. The blink back. An intense play. It could be a close one, though. Will they survive enough? They got to get the stim up here. Is it going to be enough? They come up. It's down to 300 on the shield. It's still taking damage. 60, 50, and 0. It's down. Barely. They almost held on. We see an immediate gas 1. Gas 2. We got a gas from pink. Gas from red. Blue, instead of the gas, is going to drop a Tier 2 tech. They are continuing to push forward. Scan comes down just to alleviate the pressure from these phonies, these hallucinated Archons, but they'll want to get some detection pretty soon. There is a DT for orange. We do see yellow and pink have both decided to go up for Tier 2 as well. No other gas has been dropped besides pink and red trying to push that advantage, and they are doing exactly that, pushing the advantage. Continuing to get this extra income. If we go to the income tab, you can see the extra income looking pretty nice. Now, blue's only about 50 ahead because they didn't decide to take that extra. They decided to go up for the Tier 2, but they only did that for the upgrades. You'll notice they're at 2-1 now. No Tier 2 units have been dropped by blue just yet. Still sticking with bio. Red will finally go down, but it's not going to leave a lot here for yellow. Yellow going to put almost all of that into the soak of those hallucinated Archons, and we will need to see detection up here for these teams eventually. As cloak is going to become an issue, we'll need to see some observers hopefully dropped by some of these players. Orange spreading out, trying to stay alive with the Blink Micro. Blink is auto-cast as well. You can turn it off, do it manually, or it is also auto-cast when they are low on health. Damage pushes through. They have to continue to scan. To look for these hallucinations that are causing a pretty big issue. And they probably just want to grab an observer at some point, but right now, the squirters are, oh, what a blink! What a sick blink there! That was absolutely disgusting. Blink's back, doesn't get hit by the disruptor. Blinks again to let the planetary fortress try to do some work. The blink back over here, the blink micro from both these teams is absolutely insane. And now we have a stack. Will this stack work to push all the way across? I don't think it'll be enough. Certainly not to push all the way across. Blue has dropped a first gas. We have a second gas here. One gas apiece up top. This is a weird concave here. The units all lined straight up. The blink back can be dangerous. They're gonna have to do that again. That's what they're gonna do. They're gonna keep doing that and trying to get these to stack behind. It's not a bad play to try to get back into it. They blink forward. A misclick maybe, I don't know. This is looking pretty rough so far. 1-1 and 2, still the 1-1-1 gas. No tier 3 just yet. A lot of pressure being put on here. The blink goes through, but a second one comes around. This is going to be some damage from the right side onto the planetary fortress. This immortal right here, you can see it's taking the shots. It's down to 260. Will we see some damage go down? And it is going to not quite do any damage. All that shield will repair, but will it be in time? The ping has come through saying, hey, there's liberators on the field. We need to be careful. The blink underneath them, excellent play. Will they be able to get this one as well? Yes, they get all the liberators, but there's more here for yellow. And it looks like liberators for both of them is the call. So far it's working. They are pushing back slowly but surely. Void Ray's already on the field to try to start denying both the medevacs and these liberators their purchase in the air. The blink over to the side to try to get a nice concave over and around Rappin. Tier 3 going up for blue here. As pressure mounts towards the front. Red doing a good job with the Void Rays. Void Rays are going to be pretty difficult, and right now it really is looking. Disruptor shots come out. It's looking grim for Team Squirters. But they are continuing to use. They're continuing to use the planetary to try to get some extra shots and keep them alive. That's exactly what's happening here. These liberators are going to try to stack up with more liberators back here. Void rays are here, though, to cause problems. Vikings will begin to do something about that. Tier 3 for blue has come through. And it will be for three upgrades as they continue to build bio. Two excellent disruptor shots there. Are these liberators going to be able to live through the Void Rays? I'm not entirely sure. Liberators at 1-1, Void Rays at 0-0-1. And they are. They actually survived through. They will not last long here, though. That is a lot of bio. Holy, that's a lot of bio. And upgraded bio at that. 2-2 against 3-3. Even with medevacs, it's going to be rough. Gets through and now can start chewing through these medevacs. They have started to stack up, so getting rid of some of these is going to be an excellent idea. And they continue the pressure moving forward. Disruptor shots come through. Go towards the back line. More disruptor shots through. These High Templar are not targeted by the disruptor. Storms are able to go down. More pressure coming through. Planetary Fortress being used as a weapon. And they are continuing to do a great job of beating these waves, but they need a clean victory. They need an overwhelming victory in one of these. These fights continue this way. It's just not going to go well. A lot of damage coming through. Wow, the planetary, the liberators do such a good job tearing through all of that. We do have tier 3 for red. Up towards the top. Yellow trying to hang on. Looking down here, we do have third gas, and two gas here. One apiece up top, continuing to drive home the income advantage. You can see over 100 advantage for red with the three, if they can hold on to it until it gets profitable, which will be a little bit, but already with two profiting is pretty solid. Storms are huge here for orange. Liberators do take their siege mode. And they are pushing back somehow, some way. The mothership is out. And this is going to be pretty frustrating to deal with. Not a lot of detection. We'll have to be scanning, but that does not happen fast enough. The mothership with so much health, 700, 350 of that in shields, 350 as health. And it is cloaking so much, causing so many problems. There's just not enough to bring it down right now. A lot of Vikings right here should be able to finally bring this down. But that is exactly what they were saving up for. That's why the pushback was happening, because they were saving up 900 to grab that mothership, and they do. It's out on the field, and it's already causing problems. With 3-3 as well, it is going to take a while for that thing to go down. A bunch of damage coming in here from blue. This could be it, ladies and gentlemen. Is this it? I think it just might be. The damage goes through. There it is. Game two. game, or I'm sorry, game three goes to Pew Power, and now they lead 2-1 against the previous champs. All right. So, an excellent match so far. We're up 2-1 against the defending champs. And we'll see if they're able to to hang on. It's gonna be it's probably gonna be a little bit difficult. We're gonna try to turn the sound up just a tweak here. What, like 27? 27 should be fine. I feel like this, the in-game noises can be a little bit louder. So this is 2-1. And we will see. Let's see. What's the play? So at the beginning, it's just, I can't believe that they almost got the kill, and then it wasn't enough. So they got down to 24, if I remember right, 24 or 25. So close. Now, moving into game number 4 of the series, down 2-1. It's really going to come down to it. Let's see if we can crown a new champion here with Pew Pew Prince, V, and J. And let's say we are ready. We have Terran Protoss, Terran versus Protoss, Terran Protoss. No Zerg still. They are maintaining this Terran versus Protoss in every single matchup. And that's not going anywhere, apparently. So that's going to be staying that way. And, I guess that's the way it is. No Zerg. For anybody who wanted to do Zerg in the final, I'm sorry. No Zerg. No Zerg for you. As we now get right back into it. Goliath walks out into the water. Excellent. Let's see. Our first match will be Forestalkers versus nothing. Once again, Triss allowing the early change. I wonder what the thought is here. But we'll see. We'll see what can happen. Going back and out. So here we are going to have Marauders versus Stalkers. That's going to be interesting. We have a line. We have a lineup here and nothing on orange. Let's check our production. We do have orange going up for that tier 2 again. And we do have the free money acquiring here early because orange and yellow both have not purchased anything. They are leaving it open, at least for the time being. So this will be some added damage, but this will also give orange an easy in to what they need to do to counter what blue is doing here. As you do see them like ships in a night, ships in a night, ships in the night. So We'll have to see. I think with Stim here, this should go in favor of Bio. No blink, so it's definitely going to go in favor of Bio. Purple immediately does decide to go up for tier two. More Bio coming through here. A scan to ignore the hallucination and get rid of all the other units, which is exactly what happens. I almost wonder if they even needed that help. Here come the other Marines. The Marines for blue. No stim pack. Does have the upgraded combat shield for the extra life. These Archons will make short work of the Marines here. An Adept in back doing extra damage as well. Glaives, getting the Glaives upgrade will be very, very good for moving forward against Bio, especially light units. No gas, as to be expected. Advantage actually is pushing the other direction. It's worth noting we are now, even with the early give, being able to counter is so important. And we do see the Stalkers make short work of the Marines. So looking at our lineups here, we do see the tier two is gonna go up for purple here. So actually they had canceled that earlier, didn't they? And they just canceled it again. And now they're gonna do it again. Okay, really you're trying to decide if that's what they wanna do. So damage coming through here, a lot of Marauders, but a lot of damage onto the bunker. They get through the shield, they're down to 521. And these Adepts are actually going to do some nice damage to these front units. And they're going to soak up quite a bit of damage as well, leaving the Stalkers to be able to do their extra damage on armored units to the Marauders who are out in front. This, on the other hand, will not be near as clean. But we do have a similar setup with the Adepts and the Stalkers going up against Bio. Not going for Zealots here as a front line, deciding to get the Adepts instead, where they'll be able to live a little bit longer. Blinking backwards, the Bio does finally find its way to the front. 1-1 upgrades for both of these units. Red with 1-1 as well. Unable to get up in time to do any more damage to the bunker. And that's exactly what Red would have wanted. They still take some damage. But the money advantage here is in favor. Advantage right now is in favor of Pew Power. Marines with the slightly shorter range getting up in front are going to go down to the Adepts, who are also going to get up in front with the shorter range of the Stalkers, the shorter range than the Stalkers. Archons are doing damage. You have the Immortal in back, chipping away at the Stalkers. That's a huge disruptor shot. There's still so much Bio for blue, though. And Pew has typed GG. Well, that's going to be awkward. Damage coming through. We're at the 6 minute mark. Blue with the tier two, with tier two here, that is V Serb. And this actually almost stacks up. Is it going to be enough? The disruptor shot goes through, but it's not on the bio. There's some shots on the bio, but blue gets through that, no problem. We'll be able to get up here. Are they gonna be able to get up in time? Triggers the stim, bunker taking a little bit of damage. 1-1 here. They got the second upgrade, actually. A lot of upgrades. A lot of upgrades here for purple. 1-1 and 2. That's insane. We got 2-1 here and 1-1-1. Red finally going to decide to go up to tier 2. Pink doing a great job here. A nice blink back to try to save these from the immortal shots. The stack is continuing to put on a lot of pressure towards this bunker. Those storms are pretty good, but this could be damage onto the bunker, and that's exactly what's going to happen. It's going to be a nice little wraparound here. Are they going to be able to do some damage? Down to 4, down to 3, down to 2, down to 1, and is it? It does! It goes down! The bunker goes down. And Pink immediately has gas and goes up to tier 2. Another gas goes down. We have a gas for each, for all three of these players. Damage through. That extra is going to be so hard to come back from. No gas towards topside. Scan comes through. You can see the storms come down from these high Templar. These Reapers, there's some Reapers in here to try to mess this up a little bit. But right now, the pressure, it's going to be rough. It's going to be rough to come back from. Especially when you have so many blink stalkers that are just blinking back. They're going to stack up. They're going to get more. They're going to get their shield back. Now, the problem here, this bio does very well against this army. A lot of them are taking damage, though, and if any of them can stay alive, you start to get a really big stack. The Storm of Pew Power. These Immortals, I'm surprised these Immortals are not doing near as much work as you would expect them to. There's so many stalkers, and this stack, we could start to see it. They get through that wave. That's a big punch. This could be it. We zoom in on the action. This could be it. Oh my, there's nobody spawning. It's open season for all of them to get onto this fortress. Is this gonna be your new champion? It's so close, down to 800. Nice damage there. Tier 3 is going down for purple. Continuing to get the upgrades with 2-2. 1-2-2 so far. Damage continuing. Moving forward. Aggressive play, and they almost made it happen. The scan, they see no gas, and they point it out saying, hey, this is gasless. Now blue's coming in, didn't get the same clear. Nice little disruptor shot there. Blue's bio is insane. And here it is, ladies and gentlemen. Here is Gash and the Liberators. I'm copywriting that band name. The blink underneath to try to get them to both set up a little bit early and to try to kill them, but the kill does not come through. And this could be unfortunate. We do see blue going up for that tier 3 as well. Cut back to the action. Storm and Void Rays go down. 2-2 on blue for upgrades. Orange has 2-2 as well, but the 2 is for the shields, considering the Archon with only 10 health. That means these immortals are not going to quite get the same benefit. They want to have the armor on their health instead. The fight is meandering back, but once again, the mothership comes forward. They stack up stalkers over on right side to try to kill these liberators, which actually does not happen, surprisingly. This mothership is not doing much. The storms are, though. Oh, wait a second. Wait a second. Is this real life? Is this real life? Are they turning this around? The storms come down. Can they get through the bio? It's so close. It is so close, and I don't think they can, just barely, but they are fighting for it. The mothership may have been too much of a money sink here. We'll find out. The Blinkstalker staying alive for so long. Viking stuck shooting the mothership, but it's soaking so much damage. Here's the warp that goes down, slowing units down in that area. The fight is still moving forward. The bio from yellow and the healing from these medevacs. These medevacs are helping out so much trying to push this forward. This is teetering on the edge. Can they seriously bring this back? A ton of bio for blue. The storms go down. I don't know if it's going to be enough, and we may see this surge back in favor of Pew Power, and that is what happens. I can't believe that that almost got all the way back over. Liberators making short work of the Marines, making short work of anything. These Vikings are not going to be long for this world. Damage comes forward. The Archons are trying to make it happen. 2-2-2 for Orange right now. Storms are going to come in. Perfect on this big group. We have 3-3-2. For purple, 2-2-2 for pink, and 3-3 on the bio of blue. Squirters are making a game of it, trying their best. These liberators are keeping their hopes and dreams alive. 2-2 on those liberators. The time it takes for them to siege up, though, is the reason why they are susceptible. In that time, you can take them out before they set up and start doing their damage. Still had the 877 on there. Untouched. 2-2-1 gas with 1-1-0. Interesting here. They just dropped the gas for Gash. Republica has a gas profiting, and no gas on Triss. This is where we could start to see this spin out of control. The bio continues to push forward. We do have the mothership hiding, trying to hide as much of this bio as possible. Also soaking up quite a bit of damage. Vikings land to try to stymie some of this pressure moving forward. Right now, they would want to fight with the planetary. If they lose, that will be it. Your champion, new champion, will be crowned. Yellow is doing everything they can to try to hold off here. But now we have a stack happening. Mothership finally does go down. Does pink have enough to actually get through all of these Archons? Right now, it's not looking like it. All these Immortals soaking a lot of damage and dealing out a lot of damage as well. A bunch of Vikings doing not doing much of anything here. Blue's bio wave is insane. The 3-3, could this be it, ladies and gentlemen? Could we see a new champion? That's exactly what's gonna happen here. Is it gonna happen? 70-45, there it is! Victory, Pew Power, ladies and gentlemen. Your new tournament. Standard tournament champions in Direct Strike. Congratulations to them. Wow. What a series. I can't believe it. That was absolutely outstanding. Absolutely outstanding. Well done to them. Well deserved. And great, great matches. Cheers, guys. My name is Bax. I've been here to broadcast this for you, and I had a great time. Hope you guys had a good time as well. I know there were some delays in there and stuff. That's just going to happen with tournaments. You know, it happens, and it's rough, and that's what you do. That's what has to happen. So we got there, though. We made it to the end, and we crowned a new champion. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Have a wonderful weekend. Whatever it is that you will be doing, I hope you have a great time. And I will catch you guys, hopefully, in a future tournament, or see you out on the field. I'm playing this game every once in a while. Maybe I'll see you out there, guys. Cheers, thank you again for watching. You guys are nuts. Have a wonderful rest of your day.